Hello and welcome to the first video of the Patient Monitoring 101 video series. This video series will talk about different subsystems, monitoring techniques, component selections, and other technical details for multi-parameter patient monitors and medical sensor patches for remote monitoring. By definition, a multi-parameter patient monitor measures multiple parameters like electrocardiogram, or ECG, blood oxygen concentration, or SpO2, temperature, blood pressure, carbon dioxide, or CO2, and multiple other gases. These parameters are typically measured by using isolated modules which can be connected to the main unit, called monitor. Here is an example of a patient monitor with different connectors where all these different cables get connected. These type of patient monitors are bedside or classic patient monitors, which are seen in hospitals and clinics. There is also a trend of moving towards portable patient monitors, which are small units that can be worn on the waist or the arm. The advantage of such portable type patient monitors is patient mobility. However, the challenges for these patient monitors are not only size, but also quiescent current and efficiency with thermal performance. Let's start with the ECG module. This module allows users to monitor the heart activity in real time by recording the electrical signals of the heart muscles using electrodes placed over the skin. The key system requirements for the ECG module are as follows: high signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR, to accurately detect the small electrical changes and minimize the noise for proper reproduction of the heart activity; RLD, or right leg driver circuitry, to reduce common mode interference and to bias the patient to proper voltage range of the ADC; lead-off detection circuitry, to determine electrode contact quality and thus preventing erroneous data; ultra-low power consumption, for longer operation; good circuit design to overcome common sources of irregular ECG readings. Apart from these system requirements, the isolation has to be taken care of for patient safety purpose. A common block diagram for such ECG modules is also shown in this slide. The second module is the SpO2 module. This module uses an optical setup to monitor the heart rate and peripheral oxygen saturation, or SpO2 percentage, of blood. The monitoring is done by driving red and IR LEDs alternatively through an analog switch. Depending on the concentration of HB and HbO2, the absorption of these two wavelengths vary. These changes in light intensity are converted into electrical signals by a photodiode. The received signals are then signal conditioned using TIAA, filters, and an ADC, and processed by the MCU to derive the SpO2 percentage using algorithms. The key system requirements for the SpO2 module are as follows: ambient noise cancellation and DC offset correction to subtract the noise introduced due to ambient light in order to improve the signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR. Temperature compensation for eliminating effects of temperature drift on LED driver and photodiode sensing. Motion compensation to prevent artifacts due to motion. Small form factor for easy adaption to portable applications. Low power consumption to maximize battery life while driving multiple LEDs, for example red or infrared. A common block diagram for such SpO2 modules is shown in this slide. The third module is the temperature module. This module allows users to effortlessly monitor the body temperature in real time. It is mainly used for patient diagnostics. A thermistor or similar temperature sensor is placed in contact with the body, whose resistance changes with temperature variations. The analog front end, or AFE, converts the signal picked up by the sensors into equivalent voltage, amplifies the signal, and sends it to the processor for temperature calculations. The key requirements for the temperature module are as follows: highly accurate sensor for correct temperature measurements within the specified body temperature range. The sensing data can also be used to calculate core body temperatures. Quick calibration to yield correct readings without much delay. A common block diagram for such temperature modules is also shown in the slide. The fourth module is a non-invasive blood pressure, or NIBP, module. This module easily captures blood pressure data over long sampling periods. An automatic blood pressure monitor inflates or deflates a cuff wrapped to regulate the blood flow in the artery. A pressure sensor is used to capture the exact instance when blood just begins to flow through the artery and when the blood flow is no longer restricted. the measurement of which gives the systolic and diastolic pressure, respectively. The picked-up signal is conditioned and digitized by the analog front end, or AFE, and processed further by the MCU. The key system requirements for the NIBP module are as follows. Precise and efficient control of the pump and valve. To regulate the cuff's inflation and deflation, and prevent any discomfort since continuous operation might be desired. Sensitive analog signal conditioning, to efficiently detect the small pressure changes and avoid errors in measurement. A common block diagram for such NIBP modules is also shown in this slide. The fifth module is an invasive blood pressure, or IBP module. Invasive, or intra-arterial blood pressure, is a form of continuous monitoring used in intensive care units, or ICUs, for patients who are likely to display sudden changes in blood pressure or in patients receiving drugs to maintain the blood pressure. The technique involves the insertion of a catheter into a suitable artery, which is connected to a tubing filled with fluid. This fluid moves whenever there is any change in the pressure. A pressure transducer is connected to the tubing, which detects these pressure changes and converts them into corresponding electrical signals. The key system requirements for an IDP module are as follows. High signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR, to accurately detect the small electrical changes and minimize the noise for proper reproduction of the pulsing blood. Safety features, such as high and low mean blood pressure alarms and tachycardia or bradycardia alerts. A common block diagram for such IBP modules is also shown in this slide. The wearable patient monitor market is growing fast. Remote patient monitoring equipment provides a glimpse into the future of the Internet of Things in healthcare by enabling physicians to monitor patients in real time. Remote patient monitoring provides patient information on an outpatient basis, saving patients and physicians time. Patient mobility has also become a trend. Using a secure connection to a wireless network, remote patient monitoring devices enable patients to leave the hospital sooner and forego extensive cables. Today's wearable medical products not only measure vital signs, but can also act as personal emergency response systems. If we look at the overall system, typically we have multi-parameter patient monitors which have connection to nurses' stations or doctors' offices through Wi-Fi. The different medical sensor patches connected to different patients can communicate with the same patient monitor through Bluetooth, which help in the monitoring of vital signs, but they do have a few challenges. Let's have a look at some of the sensor patches. A temperature sensor patch is a monitoring unit which allows users to effortlessly monitor the body temperature in real time. It is mainly used for patient diagnostics. Temperature sensors detect the temperature of the body, and depending on the type of temperature sensor, analog or digital, this signal is conditioned by an analog front end before getting processed by the MCU. The processed temperature data can be displayed on a computer or mobile phone, typically through a wireless interface. The key system requirements for temperature sensor modules are the following. Low cost for disposable patches. Highly accurate sensor for correct temperature measurements within the specified body temperature range. Small form factor for easy incorporation to wearable applications. Efficient, low power, and battery management to provide longer battery life for quick data transfer. To allow real-time monitoring. Wireless connectivity to remotely monitor temperature changes. A common block diagram for a temperature sensor patch is also shown in this slide. An ECG patch allows users to effortlessly monitor the heart activity in real time. It is an independent unit with power and wireless modules and allows the person to be completely mobile by eliminating the use of long cables. Typical configurations use one lead or two leads. The analog front end amplifies the ECG signals and converts it into digital data for further processing and analysis. A RLD, or right leg drive circuit, helps in canceling common mode, AC line, interference. The patches are powered using batteries with a typical runtime of 7 days for coin cell or 24 hours for a rechargeable 1S battery. The resultant data can be transferred via BLE or Wi-Fi to a computer or buttons can be displayed. The key system requirements for ECG sensor modules are the following. Low cost for disposable patches. Small form factor for easy incorporation in wearable applications. efficient battery management and ultra-low power consumption for longer operation, high signal-to-noise ratio, SNR, to accurately capture the low amplitude and low frequency electrical signals of the heart and minimize the noise, quick data transfer to allow real-time monitoring. A common block diagram for an ECG patch is also shown in the slide. A multi-parameter sensor patch can monitor the heart activity, body temperature, and blood oxygen saturation to provide a holistic view of the well-being of the person. The patch has multiple sensors, ECG electrodes, temperature sensor, and optical sensors placed on the body. These sensors pick up their respective signal and send them to the respective front ends for signal conditioning and digitization. The MCU gathers all the data, processes them individually, and sends out the measurements to a remote terminal, typically through a wireless interface. With the advancements in technology, measurements of more parameters like breathing rate, blood glucose, galvanic skin resistance, etc., are being incorporated in these patches. The key system requirements for multi-parameter sensor modules are the following. Low cost for disposable patches. Small form factor to incorporate all these functionalities without drastically increasing the device dimensions. Efficient battery management and ultra-low power consumption for longer operation. High SNR and noise cancellation to accurately capture the signals and prevent them from getting corrupted by noise. Quick data transfer and wireless connectivity to remotely monitor all the data. A common block diagram for a multi-parameter patch. With all these introduction slides for different patient monitoring subsystems, here is a glimpse of what to expect in this video series. We will discuss understanding ECG basics and lead derivation, key considerations for designing ECG front-end circuit, discrete and integrated, choosing right ECG front-end for your design, electrode configurations and interface circuitry for ECG in wearable device, understanding PPG measurement basics, transmissive versus reflective type, analog and digital temperature sensing, invasive and non-invasive blood pressure monitoring, achieve isolation and help ensure safety with power and data architectures, power supply design challenges for medical sensor patches, medical alarm or tone generation, industrial interfaces in multi-parameter patient monitors, and so on. This concludes our introduction video. Thank you for watching. And for more information, visit ti.com/medical.